I've got a huge surprise for Enzi, so I'm gonna go over there and grab it.
Oh my god!
Check this thing out.
Wait, is this real?
Hi, I'm Yanai. Today we're gonna be answering Enzi's question.
I use this for my homework every day. What is it made of?
That's a really great question. I use pencils all the time, but I've never really thought about how they're made. I think we should start by dissecting one and seeing what's on the inside. I'm excited, let's get to it. Sorry, little guy, we're gonna have to cut you open for science. All right, so now that we have both halves of the eraser cap pulled apart, you can feel that it's a little tacky. So I have a feeling they use some sort of special glue to attach the eraser to the wood piece. As I'm cutting it open, I can see the lead that's on the inside. The pencil has this groove that runs along the inside. I'm sure that when they make these pencils, they add some adhesive to make sure that that lead stays totally stuck to the inside of the pencil. So after dissecting the pencil, there's still a lot that I have to learn. So I'm gonna call in an expert to learn a little bit more about pencils.
My name is John Carling, and I am a professional artist and a gallery owner in Larkspur, California. My father is a woodworker, and I grew up in a wood shop.
Hey, John, it's nice to meet you, and I'm so excited to learn more about pencils from you. So what do you think actually makes a great pencil?
I would say the straightness of the pencil is important, the quality of the wood is important, and the quality of the graphite is very important. It doesn't hurt to have a nice eraser as well. There's nothing worse than trying to fix a mistake and making it bigger with an eraser that doesn't work properly.
Is there a way to get softer or harder graphite?
The hardness and smoothness of the graphite depends on the combination of clay and graphite in different amounts. So the more graphite, the softer the lead is going to be. And the more clay, the harder the lead is going to be. The smoother and softer the graphite, the darker it's going to be on the page. And the harder the graphite, the lighter the line is going to be.
I'm interested in making my own pencil, so what should I know first?
Try to make a pencil that's larger than what you're used to, just because it'll be easier to assemble.
Thank you so much, John. I really appreciate your insight. All this has helped me think through how to make a pencil. Okay, let's get building. I'm gonna go ahead and gather some materials to get started on the build. I think for my pencil, I'm gonna go for that classic hexagonal shape. All right, first I'm gonna start off with the wood, and I went ahead and picked up this 4x4. So I've called in my buddy Rob, who's gonna help us cut this thing.
All right, so we gotta do our angle cuts for the sides of the pencil.
It's starting to look like a giant pencil. I'm really happy with how this is turning out, and I'm excited to cut the rest of the shapes into it to make it into a real giant pencil.
Awesome, it's looking great.
We're gonna need some good graphite. So I went ahead and got some 100% ultra-fine graphite, and it measures 4 microns in diameter. That's like really, really small, about 20 times smaller than the width of a human hair. Because of its small size, our graphite's gonna mix really well with some clay. Because most pencil companies keep their recipe top secret, we're gonna have to do a bit of experimentation to find out what mixture of graphite and clay we need to make the perfect pencil. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is mix up batches of different mixtures of clay and graphite to see what writes the best. Like John said, the ratio of clay to graphite determines how hard or soft a pencil is, or how light and dark it is. We can put this in an oven to see if we can get rid of some of that excess moisture. All right, I'm gonna start with this one right here, and this one is gonna be the hardest pencil. Hopefully it'll have the lightest tone, and then this will be darker, this one will be darker than that, and this one will be the darkest pencil. And look at that, we got a line, there we go, working pencils. I'm really happy with this actually, I think it looks great. I think we should try out the next one. And this one has one extra scoop of graphite. So this one will be slightly darker than the last one and a little bit softer. So let's try this thing out. If you look at the paper, this one compared to the last one left a ton more crumbs on the paper. And I think that's because there's less clay to hold everything together. All right, here's number 3. We got 2 extra scoops of graphite in this one. Look at that. It's so cool to see the differences in colors between just adding like 1 extra scoop of graphite. I would say of the 3, the 4th definitely is the darkest. The 1st is by far the lightest. And it's also interesting to see the hardness because you can see that as well on the paper. All right, so I'm just sketching out what I want the lead piece to look like. And I'm going for a smaller piece of lead here. That way we don't have to core out the entire pencil like they would in an actual pencil factory. Because at this scale, it's gonna be pretty difficult to do that. What's neat about this is now I can interchange the different hardnesses of graphite. Most erasers today are made out of a synthetic rubber. The way it works is through a little science concept called friction. Friction is a force that happens when two things rub together to create heat. What's really unique is that the eraser is strong enough to pick up those graphite particles, but not strong enough to rip the paper, because that would cause a lot of problems. For my eraser, I'm going to be using this polymer clay. And this stuff has a rubbery texture to it, and it's easily moldable. What's also neat about this stuff is you can add color, and that's going to give this eraser that signature pink look. But don't worry, this stuff is still going to do a great job of picking up the graphite off the paper. All right, so I finished up my eraser, and it's looking great, and I'm ready to start baking this thing so I can start working on the ferrule. The ferrule is what's going to help me attach this eraser to the pencil body. This metal piece hugs the eraser and keeps it in place, and you can see there's a ton of detail inside of it. What's really cool is that we have access to 3D printers, so we'll be able to get the same amount of detail that you wouldn't be able to get by using metal. Alright, so I just went ahead and let this thing bake, so now I'm going to glue it, and boom! We have our finished pencil eraser. All right, after 2 days of work, I've finally assembled all the components I'm gonna need to build this giant pencil. We've got an eraser, check. Our pencil body with the correct shape and good quality wood, check. And we've got our pencil lead with a few different hardnesses of lead, check. I'm so happy that Enzi asked me this question. After 2 long days of work, I'm pretty sure I know why nobody's making 6-foot pencils, but I'm glad I did because I learned so much about them, and I'm pretty excited to show this thing to Enzi and see his reaction. So I've got the pencil here. He has no idea, and I can't wait to see his reaction. Hey Enzi, I'm coming in. You ready to see your surprise? Check this thing out.
Oh my god! Wait, is this a real eraser? Oh my god! Wait, is this real?
Should we go test it out? We've got a huge paper over there. Here we go. What do you think this thing is made out of?
Wood.
Okay, and what about the eraser? So the eraser is actually made of polymer clay, and so we shaped it to make it look like a real eraser. So Enzi, what makes a good pencil?
Graphite, wood, and eraser. My hand's bigger than his.
All right, high five.
Right here.
See how tall I am. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to see more cool videos like this, make sure to like and subscribe.
Bye.
Thanks for coming to KiwiCo.
You're welcome. Someone opened the door for me.
Well, thank you to you and I.
Thank you.
Bye. Yeah.